What's up guys, it's Patrick. Got a different video for you today. Nothing to do with music. Today I just wanted to share a quick workflow tip for those of you who are using this bad boy, the MX Master, or in this case, the MX Master 2S. If you have an MX Master or you're looking for something to help better optimize your workflow, I have some things that I want to share with you. I've been using the Apple Trackpad for a lot of years. As you can see, I'm still rocking with the Gen 1. And anybody who does any graphic design, or you produce and mix music, or you edit video, the Trackpad isn't the most precise option available. Hanging out in the YouTube community, listening to a lot of folks who do the same things that I do, figured I would check out this MX Master. Everybody talks about it. They say it's a great workflow mouse, great for video editing. But for those of you who don't know me and may just be stumbling upon this video, I write and produce music, so I bought this mouse hoping that it would also be good for music editing. This came in the mail yesterday. I opened it up, obviously didn't even bother with the directions. Turned it on, started using it, and immediately realized how much I missed OS gestures. Yes, this mouse does come already set up with some of the gesture features, but it wasn't perfect. There's some key gestures that I use a lot that weren't mapped out on this mouse. So of course I started looking online for the perfect mouse setup, couldn't find anything. I just wanted to share this quick for those of you who are using this mouse or maybe struggling to find the perfect settings like I was. So all of my setting choices are gonna be based around trying to get this to behave as much like this while being more ergonomic and more comfortable and just faster. That's what I want, just fast. Anyway, once you get the mouse turned on, connected, you want to go to the Logitech website, download the Logitech Options app, pull that up. It's going to look a little like this. So if we start over on the point and scroll section, a lot of this is preference. A couple of the settings that I did change, the thumbwheel speed pretty much maxed this out. It was pretty slow. Pointer speed, scrolling speed, that's all preference. I think I enabled free spin and smooth scrolling. Either way, I like those settings because it mimics the scrolling on the trackpad, which has that nice fluidity when you're going up and down a page. I like that. But those are just my settings for reference. This is really preferential. Do whatever you want here. But over here in the mouse section, this is where things get really customizable. Logitech gave you all the freedom you want to make this mouse completely your own. So let's dive in. The middle button here, I left alone. Some people like to use the little scroll wheel as a clicky function. I don't. So first let's go over to this little side thumb button here. Now this comes mapped as your main gesture button. And personally, I don't love this button and I use gestures quite a bit. So I wanted to change this. One of the features that I found that I really missed moving from the trackpad to the MX Master was the pinch zoom feature. And fortunately, Logitech gives you the option to map that function. So I'm a happy camper. So you go over here, you click zoom using scroll wheel. And now as you can see, all you have to do, press the side button, scroll in and out using the scroll wheel. It's really nice and it's kind of the only way this makes sense. You can't scroll to zoom with the middle button. Now let's get into the gestures. I remapped this to this little middle button here. And as it comes set up, it's still not quite perfect, so I customized those settings further. So let me show you that. First, what you want to do is you want to go to this middle button and you want to select gesture. Now the way this gesture button setting defaults, it's not bad. It comes in this window navigation setting, but I think if you click custom and then customize these settings, you're gonna be a little bit happier. So if you come over here, you click this customize feature, you're brought to this menu. You get 5 different settings to customize, so let me just show you what I chose. The first setting I'll go over is if you just tap this center button. Show desktop was one of the features that was not originally mapped out. It's a setting that I use and I wanted to have it. So if you go down to this button, you see that you can select show desktop. You can put whatever you want here, but this is just a setting that I used. So now you can see if I click this button, all my windows go away like magic. So let me just bring in a couple more windows so I can demonstrate these a little bit better. The forward gesture and the back gesture come mapped as mission control and app expose respectively. And I like that. It's really intuitive coming over from the trackpad, and I just kept those the same just to show you. Boom, move up, there's mission control. And then boom, moving back, there's your app expose. I like that. I like leaving those the same. Now the swiping between desktops is something that I really use. And for me, my keyboard shortcut wasn't set right, so this feature did not work with the MX Master, but let me show you how to fix this. So if you pull up your system preferences, you go into keyboard, you have these shortcuts, you select mission control, then you come over here to your mission control features. For whatever reason, move left a space and move right a space were mapped as something different. So all you do, you double click on this, you say control left, and then over here to move right, you say control right. Those are the settings that the MX Master will recognize. This may change things with your keyboard shortcuts if you use it that way. There may be another way to do this. If you figured something different out, leave it in the comments below. So now moving the mouse right and left when you have your gesture button selected will allow you to switch between your desktops. But there's one more thing that I did. So when you're using the trackpad, navigating through your windows is more like a swipe motion. You're not dragging your fingers towards the left in order to move left. You're swiping from left to right in order to move to the left. And it's really intuitive and it works really well and it's the way that I like it. And it wasn't mapped that way in the default settings on the MX Master. So all you're gonna do is invert these. Again, this is just my preference. It feels really intuitive to me, especially when coming over from the trackpad. You're gonna take this desktop left arrow and you're gonna say desktop right. And this desktop right arrow, you're gonna select desktop left. Now, when you move between windows, it feels just like it does on your trackpad. Now, when I come over and work in Logic, everything is really intuitive, scrolling back and forth between my projects. If I wanna zoom in, we got that. Can also get our vertical zoom and our horizontal zoom. It all works together really nice. The settings for the thumb wheel and the forward and back buttons, I left as is, they work perfectly fine for me. Anyway guys, I know this is a different video for me, but I thought I would just share these settings that I found to be really useful for anybody who is searching through the internet. So far, I'm really liking this mouse. It's great for video editing, pretty solid for editing music. I will, however, be keeping my trusty trackpad Gen 1 close by, just in case, just for a little security. For those of you who maybe found this video searching through YouTube, maybe you want to come over to the channel, check things out. See how you like it, see how it feels. Maybe drop a subscribe, join the family. Trust me, we got room. But until next time, my name's Patrick. It's been a pleasure hanging out with you today. I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.